The Sign of Zorro by Johnston McCulley, read by Bill Homewood for Naxos AudioBooks. Chapter 1. Call Out the Fox. Beside a narrow, filthy passageway, not far from the corner of the plaza in Reina de los Angeles, sat the small adobe hut of Bardoso, the one-eyed reformed pirate. And just now, Bardoso sat beside his hut. Easy living had put the fat on Bardoso in thick layers. Since he had forsaken these, he had done little work and had taken no exercise to keep his muscles hard and his body lean. And he was noted for the amazing amount of food and drink he could consume. Some said Bardoso lived on the bloody rewards of his piracy. Others pointed out that in that case the rewards must have been small indeed, for Bardoso lived much like a pig in its sty. Yet there was always meat for his cooking pot and wine for his private wineskin. He received gifts of food and drink in return for his wild tales about the dubious glories of piracy. He had his own shelter, and a few rags sufficed to cover his nakedness. He merely ate, drank, and slept, slowly rotting away. Yet it was strange that this Bardoso had several friends in high places, a grandee or two, a few gay young caballeros, even old Fray Felipe, formerly stationed at the chapel in Reno de los Angeles, and now at Mission Santa Barbara, 100 miles to the north. They seemed to have a special liking for the reformed pirate, and often stopped to chat with him. On this evening, in mid-September, about the year 1800, Bardoso sat on a stool in front of his hut as the soft dusk descended. He had finished his evening meal and washed it down with a quantity of wine. He observed that the moon had not yet come up, but that stars studded a cloudless sky. A gentle breeze swept in from the distant sea to cool the heat of the day. In other huts nearby, candles were alight, children were whimpering, and dogs were barking around the plaza. Somewhere near, a guitar was being strummed, and a man's soft voice was lifted in song as he implored his love to be kind. "The fools," Bardoso muttered, the hiccup resulting from too much wine. "Soon they will stand before the padre. Then they will occupy the same heart and eat from the same pot. She will commence having brats and will grow fat, and he will beat her because she does not cook enough peppers in the frijoles. I have seen it often. It is sad, but it is life." Bardoso's left eye was missing, a little matter of a cutlass blow some years before. But he could see well enough with his good right eye, and now as he glanced through the soft purple dusk, he saw a moving shadow where none should have been. Somebody was creeping toward him stealthily. At times, Bardoso dealt profitably in certain commodities for which the governor's tariff had not been paid, so on occasion furtive men approached him with care. But thieves were abroad also, and it had been rumored that Bardoso had wealth hidden in his hut. Hence, he trusted no shadow. He pulled a pistol out of his sash and held it ready for use. It was a formidable weapon which had often served him well. He watched the shadow drift on toward him. Presently, he spoke.
"Your stealthy approach is being observed by me, senor. State your name and business immediately.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.